Let us now look at ATM layers. What are the layers in ATM? Look at the figure. This shows an ATM endpoint operational model and an ATM switch operational model. ATM endpoint operational model, what does it contain? This contains three layers. ATM adaptation layer AAL, ATM layer and the physical layer. Let's now look at them briefly. What is physical layer? The physical layer provides bit transmission, coding, electrical to optical, optical to electrical conversions, bit timing, scrambling, descrambling, error detection and error correction. If the error cannot be corrected, the cell will be discarded. It is analogous to the physical layer of the OSI reference model. The ATM physical layer manages the medium dependent transmission. The ATM physical layer has four functions. Cells are converted into serial bit stream. Bits transmission is controlled. ATM cell boundaries are kept track of. Cells are packaged into appropriate types of frames for different kinds of transmission standards. For example, the frame reassembly for Sonic is in a different format compared to an even transmission, for example. The ATM physical layer is divided into two parts. The physical medium dependent sublayer PMD, transmission convergence layer TC. Now, what are the roles of PMD? PMD has got two key functions. It controls synchronization of the transmission and reception. It specifies the physical media and the physical medium used. Examples of physical medium standards could be SGH, SONET, etc., over fiber or twisted pair, at 155 Mbps, using 8B coding and so on. This more or less completely defines a physical layer. The TC layer, on the other hand, has four functions. Cell delineation maintains ATM cell boundaries, allowing devices to locate the cells. Header error control. This is a sequence generation and verification. This does error control functions. Cell rate decoupling. This handles synchronization. The last one could be transmission frame adaptation. This packages ATM cells into appropriate frames for different transmission standards. These are the four functions of TC sublayer. We'll continue with the ATM layers. Look at the animation. This ATM layer performs the following functions related to routing of cell packets. It adds cell header and removes cell header. The VPI VCE values of incoming cell is translated to a new VPI VCE value for the outgoing cell. It also controls generic flow to determine the destination of the receiving cell. It multiplexes and demultiplexes cell. Combined with the ATM adaptation layer, the ATM layer is roughly analogous to the data link layer of the famous OSI reference model. The ATM layer is responsible for two things. First one, the simultaneous sharing of virtual circuits over the physical link, which is called cell multiplexing. The second one, passing cells through the ATM network itself, which is called the cell relay. To do this, it uses the VPI and VCI information in the header of each ATM cell. We will continue with the ATM layers. Let us look at ATM adaptation layer, AAL. This AAL converts the input data stream of the upper layer to chunks of 48 bytes for the ATM cell payload packaging. The AAL is divided into two sublayers. They are the convergence sublayer CS and the segmentation and reassembly sublayer SAR, which is shown in the figure. Combined with ATM layer, the AAL is roughly analogous to the data link layer of the OSI model. The AAL is responsible for isolating higher layer protocols from the details of ATM process. The adaptation layer prepares user data for conversion into cells and segments the data into 48 byte cell payloads. Finally, the higher layers residing above the AAL accept user data, arrange it into packets and hand it to the AAL. This figure illustrates the ATM reference model pretty clearly. ATM is designed to interface with various applications. Therefore, different types of AALs are needed to provide service to the upper layer applications. The AALs are divided into four classes of traffic, namely class A, class B, class C and class D. Also, AAL is divided into four types of AAL protocol, namely type 1, type 2, type 3/4 and type 5. The table below represents a very comprehensive picture of the service classifications of ATM AALs and the role of each of these layers. The convergence sublayer CS converts the information stream into four types of packet streams called AAL. As mentioned just now, the four layers are type 1, type 2, type 3/4 and type 5. The packet formats should match the five types of ATM services already described. They are constant bitrate CBR, variable bitrate non-real-time VBR NRT, variable bitrate real-time VBR RT, available bitrate ABR and unspecified bitrate UBR. We have seen them briefly earlier on. CS tasks are likely to be application dependent. Hence, CS is further subdivided into the upper service specific CS, SSCS and lower common part SS, CPCS. SAR tasks are quite standard depending only on traffic type. The SAR segments the SDU received from CS and add necessary overhead and convert them into 48 byte cells or protocol data units, PDU.